Hello, welcome to Accounting Hub. I'm Professor George Scarpin, PhD in accounting, and our topic today is inventory write-down. And what do we have here? Subsequent measurement of inventory. Circumstances arrived after purchase or production of inventory that indicated the company will sell inventory for less than the cost. Inventory damage, physical deterioration, obsolescence, changing price levels, and so on. Everything decreases our ability to sell. And US GAAP and IFRS requires that company evaluate their unsold inventory at the end of each reporting period. And here, I think this is one of the hardest topics on inventories, because we have two methods. Two approaches. We have lower of cost or net realizable value. Usually we work with companies that work with FIFO or LIFO. So we have here for everybody. Lower of cost or market only for LIFO or retail inventory method. So the lower of cost or market usually is for the US only. However, we have some countries that allows lower of cost or market as well. Okay, so let's work first with the lower of cost or net realizable value. So what is net realizable value? Is the estimated selling price less the cost of completion, disposal, and transportation. So is our net revenue here. And at the end of year, a company compares the cost and the net realizable value. If net realizable value is lower than cost, then we need an adjusting entries, reducing the inventory. Let's go to our Excel file. It is much easier to work with. And remember, all our Excel files, they are free to download it. And the link is in our video description. So we have here, we have two sheets here. One for net realizable value and one for the lower cost or market. Okay, you cannot see it here. I have no idea why this window bar is here. But okay. So let's work here. Scarpin Corporation has 7 inventory items on hand at the end of the year. The end of the year costs FIFO, for instance, or any other one. And net realizable value for each company. And here, let's just change it for LIFO. And let's also change here for LIFO, because we can do that. Okay. Items A, B, and C are similar. Items and items, wow. J, K, L, and M are another collection of similar items. So we have two categories here. And each collection can be considered a category of inventory. And let's copy and paste. Okay, now we have good numbers here. So what do we have? What do we have here? These are our numbers based on costs. This is our number based on net realizable value. So we can work by individual items, category, or total. So for instance, individual items, we will take the lowest number. We can check it and put it here. However, it is not good. We have 7 here. We can have 7,000. So we need a formula here. So let's work with the minimal number. So minimum between these two. And we have them here, and we have them here. So we are working with the lowest number. So for instance, item A, the lowest is the cost. Item B, the lowest is the net realizable value. Item C, net realizable value. Item 4, net realizable value. Item 5, or K, net realizable value. L, cost. M, cost. How much is our total here? Is the sum of our items is 943. Okay? However, we can also work on category here. So we don't care about individual items. We only compare the sum of our categories here. And because this A here has a net realizable value so high, the minimum here will be the cost. So no adjusting entry would be necessary. And category 2, we do the same. And our total is also the sum here. Okay? And by total inventory, we don't compare anything here. We only compare the total. So minimum, our total here. So also the cost. Okay, and then let's choose one. So let's choose by individual items. Why? Because US GAAP allows you to choose between individual items category or total inventory. IFRS usually works with individual items only. So this is the one that we will be working with. So our inventory by cost, 965. Our inventory, according to net realizable value approach, it is 943. Wow, this T account is not balanced. We need to balance it with a credit because we need to decrease this number. How do we do? Lowest number, highest number less the lowest number, $22,500. So credit inventory. How much is our debit? Or our debit is also 22, and we are increasing the cost of goods sold. We can also create a account here, call it net realizable value or any other name here, but usually we work with the cost of goods sold. And let's work now with the lower of cost or market. Companies that use LIFO or the retail inventory method report using the lower of cost or market approach. The same cost versus market. The problem is, how do we find our market? The ceiling, the top number, is always our net realizable value. Market should not be greater than the net realizable value. And also, the floor, net realizable value less normal profit margin. Market should not be less than net realizable value reduced by an allowance for normal profit margin. And we have the middle. And let's go to our Excel file. And we also have the replacement cost. How much is the new cost of this product if we want to repurchase them again? So what do we have here? The costs, same numbers as we have here, 965. Net realizable value. Oops, net realizable value here, also the same numbers here. And to find our profit margin, we need our selling price. So this is our selling prices. So normal profit margin is our selling price times our profit. Our profit here, let's consider 5%. So here is our net profit, normal profit margin. So our bottom, our floor here, it is net realizable value less our net profit margin. Let's change this number a little bit. Let's do it with 30%. Okay. And then here we have also our replacement costs. Okay, let's do it better. Okay. So how do we find the market is the middle of our prices? How do we find the middle? And that is a tricky question. It's not the minimum or the maximum. However, if we go to business stats, what do we have? Average. We are not working with average here. Median. What is the median? If we split our sample in two, the median is the middle number. So every time we want to find the middle number, we calculate the median. And Excel gives us the median. Median. Which numbers? This is the ceiling, comma, floor, comma, replacement. And here, our middle. So our market value cannot be lower than our floor number. So, okay, this is our bottom number. And we copy and paste here. So here is our numbers. Okay, guys, sometimes let's consider that this number, instead of 94 or 70, it would be 95, for instance. Then our market would be 94, not be more than our ceiling price. Cannot be more than our net realizable value. And sometimes it can be the replacement cost, such as the K or L or M. Can be the replacement cost as well. And then, just like net realizable value here, the lower also minimum, lower cost or market. So, comma, market. Here, open paste here, that is what we have. So, okay, 770, our cost is 965. 965 less 195 is the number to balance our journal entry. And US GAAP allow you to choose IFRS, don't. And usually IFRS, they don't allow the lower of cost or market. So here, wow, it's not help. Come on. RFRS, few countries to make it clear. And when we have cost and market for all of our products, we can also work with individual, category, or total inventory, just like the net realizable value. Okay, guys, so I think you will need to watch this video more than once to get it. But this is one of the hardest topics, I know. So please, guys, check it out how many times you want. Thank you so much. Subscribe our channel. Like our Facebook page, Accounting Hub by Dr. Scarpin. Like this video. If you have questions or comments, leave it here or email me at jscarpin@gmail.com. Have a very nice day and God bless you.